This is Anjali from The Nurse of Color talking to Manjari Makijany, who is the director for the all-new Disney Channel original movie, Spin. Hi, thanks for speaking with me today.
Hi, Anjali. It's so lovely to talk to you. Thank you for having me on Nerds of Color.
You're welcome. It's so nice to have you. With Skater Girl and now Spin, you brought our culture, the Indian culture, to American television. This is great for girls like me to see themselves. What inspired you to tell the story, Spin?
Exactly that I want you guys to be able to see more people like us on screen and in leading roles and be able to celebrate our Indian culture on screen in a mainstream way, in a contemporary way, something that's fun. And when I read the script, I was like, I have to tell the story, and I want to be the one to tell the story, because such a fun story to tell. So beautiful how Rhea, really celebrates the Indian culture and her friends and her family. And I hope people can take that from the film.
Yeah, because when I was younger, I didn't see many Indian movies or girls that looked like me on TV. So now I see more movies with Indian people in it. It makes me very happy, and you inspire me very much.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. That means a lot to me. Thank you.
You've done both American and Hindi films. How do you find the balance between Indian culture and American culture when telling Rhea's story?
I think it's important to sort of be true to both of these, and I've lived in India and I've lived here. So I think understanding the dualities of these two worlds was important to bring that authenticity to Rhea's character, because she's not just Indian, she's not just American, she's Indian American. And, as an Indian American, we take our culture with us. We take that sort of heritage with us. We are celebrating festivals. We love our family and our friendships. So all of those things were so important to build into Rhea's character. And her family dynamics and her friendships and the way she sort of, even with her music, how is she going to fuse those two worlds together? So that was very important to make Rhea's character come alive and be very natural to who she is.
Yes, because I love when there's movies where they merge like two cultures together. Then it's like, it's
fun.
It includes us.
Yeah, exactly. And it was important to be inclusive because, this movie is not just for a South Asian audience. It's for everybody. And how do you make our culture and introduce our culture in a fun way? So I tried to do a little bit of that. And I hope I succeeded.
You did a very good job in including both cultures.
Oh, thank you.
I love that Rhea finds her true passion being a DJ. Like your character in Skater Girl, these characters are not the stereotypes that Hollywood places on Indian girls. What was the most important thing for you to portray for your characters?
I think it's really important to have characters who are unconventional, who are, not afraid to challenge the status quo, and who are ready to take a risk and be change agents and be trailblazers. Because I think we need more of those, don't you think? It's like we need more people doing unconventional things that inspire more people, and then they go on and do more fun stuff. So I think using just cinema and art as a medium to tell these fun stories in a way that's entertaining and yet inspiring is very important to me. And I think with both the stories somewhere, with skating and with like DJing, these are things that people think, oh, it's maybe meant for a boy, or like you don't really see a girl, let alone an Indian, a girl running with it. So it was fun sort of breaking all these stereotypes and telling the story.
Yeah, the story was very inspiring to me. Especially for a lot of Indian girls, it was very inspiring to see an India girl, and she was kind of like a leader in the story. So exactly. I really like that.
Oh, I'm glad. I hope people get inspired by that and know that we're quite badass.
What made you pursue filmmaking, and where did the dream come from?
I knew pretty early on that I wanted to be a filmmaker, when I didn't even know what a director did or what is a director's job. I realized that I want to be able to tell stories. I want to be able to, just transport people into another world and let them in a different kind of experience. And then it was really after I finished university that I realized that, you know, this is what I'm going to pursue.
Yeah, it's very hard to be a filmmaker. So
it is. It's hard, but it's not impossible. And it's and I think everybody who decides to be a filmmaker brings something very unique to the table. It's they bring their own perspective. They bring their own unique voices. And I think the more of us, the merrier, and the more sort of different stories we'll get to experience.
Yeah, there's millions of different stories, and all of them are inspiring in their own way.
Exactly.
As an Indian American woman, what roadblocks did you face when you were starting out, and how did you overcome them?
I grew up in India, and I moved here about 8 years ago. And just growing up, I didn't know how difficult it could be. I thought, I finished university, in a few years I can direct my first film. It took me 13 years to be able to do my first feature and release it to the world. So I think it does take time, and patience is something. If you want to be a filmmaker, you have to sort of know, you're running a marathon, you're not doing a 100-meter sprint. And I think just understanding that was very important, knowing that you got to have the larger goal in mind. Everything is not about instantly getting it. Everything is not about, you know, it's like, all right, I'm going to do this now, and then I get the result. It's knowing that it's okay to be patient and wait for the fruits of your labor.
Good comes to those who wait.
Exactly. You got it.
How does it feel knowing movies like these inspire girls like me to be able to put themselves out there and have the courage to pursue my dreams while breaking boundaries?
I love that. I mean, I think it's incredible. It is what makes me so happy that even if a little bit of what I do can inspire someone like you, Anjali, I think that is just the best reward I could get as a filmmaker.
And how does it feel to empower girls like me to pursue their dream beyond the expectations of an Indian girl that we typically have, you know, the traditional roles?
Yeah, I think it's incredible. I think we need more trailblazers. We need more, you know, girls in leadership positions and making decisions and doing things that people would not otherwise imagine them to do. Because it's just incredible the power when you unleash and you embrace your talent, what you can do with it, and how you can almost multiply your talent and multiply what sort of your true gift is and in a way serve others with it, because it goes on almost like a wildfire, creating more and more and more positive things. So I love that. I personally just take great pride in the fact that that Indian girls and just girls anywhere can do something that inspires other people.
Yeah, because when I was younger, I didn't see many movies and TV, yeah. Pop culture with a different perspective. Watch it on your screen, hit play, so check this.